Continue controlling this matchup, and oh my god, look at him go.
And he already lands counter strike too, so the trade comes in his favor. Oh, wait, but okay, Seiken flashes out of the tower. Memento might die from this.
Okay, he lives.
Right in the middle, so this is the perfect opportunity to move down bot side, but I believe Memento has seen this and recognized it as well. You have vision there as well, considering that deep ward. Now, if he gets to the death, he decides to make a play in mid lane. I definitely do as well, because of the locked up potential as we're seeing right now. Kabasard, there we go. That's all a single target damage. And there's that lockdown that I was saying. So late game, maybe that's cool. Now they're not, and now they're top side yet again. But, oh, Reckless.
Oh, I like
just
this.
Just caught by himself, and he goes so fast. Does he have a second to flash away? That's rough hero for them.
Yeah, and I like that. You know, Kabasard doesn't have the TP. He's no longer in the area because someone has to answer that bottom wave that was stacking. So that means it's just an easy play for them to make. Sure. Bad Lulu's TP didn't actually help too much, but the play overall I think is still good. Now he can push mid lane, and as the Herald is taken, Cody Sun can come in and shove up. It's not amounting to too much. They're making a lot of these plays. And speaking of plays, we got a TP coming through.
Yeah, gonna be a 3v3 bot side, but Counter-Strike is already operating and waiting.
Oh,
yeah, he was anticipating
here.
That. Momentum, but he stunned up. But look at the back end though. Antara locked down. There we go. They get one. Support gone and done. So that's pretty nice. Slow
one more. Oh, look at the TP. Look at
Capital. Stang's already in. Memento has learned the Q early on. But decided to try to switch it up. There we go. Bad Lulu caught it once again. And immediately onto range.
Whoa!
Oh, he switches around. He gets one. Capital's dead. That's such a big pick. Bad Lulu, you absolute animal with a big crit. He locks him here with himself. Now Cody sucking fire on away. Not ton of mana either, but those mini guys still do a lot of damage, and Seiken now gone.
Oh,
big amount
Cody
of CD taken away. Cody's not excited. He wants to go in.
Oh, this
Rama
is another
Risa.
Kill.
There we go. That's another one. Let's get rid of Bad Lulu.
Have a lot of pressure mid with this big wave Seiken has, and they can just go and take this turret as well. He's still got 30 seconds on Bad Lulu, and he's not going to be able to do much of anything here, but still a lot of damage coming through from Rungjun. Oh, the Jinx Rocket.
There's a ton of wave clear as well, considering he took away the calling. They see that they're doing a lot of damage. The Counter Strike tried to slow them down for a couple more seconds. You see, both GAs pop right now. They're trying to get away. They want to disengage. They don't want this fight. They're all so low.
And Kabasard
gone yet again.
Look at the damage.
A big bubble. Cody Sun popping off as he shows them the light. Wants one more. Momentum staying alive. Reckless is trying to get away. The ADC has to try to save the day. It's just him as he looks to kite away.
Oh, he's gonna go for it. The Q lands. Oh my god, that is a big shutdown. Look at Bad Lulu showing up. Look at these spawn timers. Mirage turned it around. They have a wave coming here. I think they're gonna end the game.
They could possibly do this, like you said. They have more than enough push. Bad Lulu is up, like you said. Memento is there. Raxo is there, considering how long spawn timer was too. He was the first one gone. He's the first one back, and he wants to go back in yet again. There's still 18 seconds on Seiken, 10 seconds on Hantera. It's not enough. Kabasard has 15 more. He's not going to be alive in time. Mirage, last time they caught out in an unfortunate team fight. In the last couple of seconds, they find retribution against K-Corp. They take down the blue wall.
Man, one.